गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम इन दिस क्लास. दिस इज क्लास 7th, सब्जेक्ट सोशल साइंस. एंड टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट सिविक्स चैप्टर 2, दैट इज रोल ऑफ गवर्नमेंट इन हेल्थ. इट इज द फर्स्ट लेक्चर ऑफ दिस चैप्टर. एंड इन टुडेज लेक्चर द टॉपिक्स विच आर टू बी डिस्कस्ड आर लाइक दिस. फर्स्ट इज व्हाट इज हेल्थ, मींस मीनिंग और डेफिनेशन ऑफ हेल्थ. सेकेंड, हेल्थ केयर सेंटर्स इन इंडिया. एंड द थर्ड वन इज अबाउट अ स्टोरी की विच इज गिवन इन योर एनसीईआरटी टेक्स्ट बुक, द स्टोरी ऑफ हकीम शेख. सो लेट्स वी स्टार्ट टूडेज डिस्कशन. एक्चुअली इन दिस चैप्टर वी विल अंडरस्टैंड हाउ द गवर्नमेंट मेक्स डिसीजंस टू इम्प्रूव द हेल्थ ऑफ द पीपल. एंड वी ऑल्सो लर्न अबाउट द कंसेप्ट ऑफ हेल्थ एंड हेल्थ केयर सेंटर्स इन इंडिया. स्टूडेंट्स, आर फर्स्ट टॉपिक रोल ऑफ गवर्नमेंट इन हेल्थ. यस, एज वी नो दैट देयर आर 3 लेवल्स ऑफ गवर्नमेंट इन इंडिया. एंड दीज 3 लेवल्स आर, फर्स्ट वन सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट, सेकेंड स्टेट गवर्नमेंट, एंड थर्ड वन इज पंचायती राज. ओके, लाइक सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट वर्क्स और परफॉर्म्स डिफरेंट फंक्शंस. सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट परफॉर्म्स डिफरेंट फंक्शंस ऑन डिफरेंट सब्जेक्ट्स. फॉर एग्जांपल मींस द सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट वर्क्स ऑन दोज सब्जेक्ट्स विच आर रिलेटेड टू द दैट विच आर रिलेटेड टू द पीपल ऑफ होल कंट्री, लाइक सब्जेक्ट्स ऑफ फाइनेंस एंड डिफेंस. एंड द स्टेट गवर्नमेंट वर्क्स ऑन द सब्जेक्ट लाइक हेल्थ एंड एजुकेशन. सो वी आर डिस्कसिंग अबाउट द टॉपिक हेल्थ. सो वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट द रोल ऑफ स्टेट गवर्नमेंट, रोल ऑफ स्टेट गवर्नमेंट इन हेल्थ. ओके, सो जस्ट आई टोल्ड मीन्स वी विल अंडरस्टैंड हाउ द गवर्नमेंट मेक्स डिसीजंस टू इम्प्रूव द हेल्थ ऑफ द पीपल. ओके, इन ए डेमोक्रेटिक कंट्री इट इज एक्सपेक्टेशन ऑफ द पीपल दैट द गवर्नमेंट वर्क फॉर देयर वेलफेयर थ्रू द प्रोविजंस ऑफ एजुकेशन, हेल्थ एंड एम्प्लॉयमेंट. ये स्टूडेंट्स, एज वी नो इंडिया इज ए डेमोक्रेटिक कंट्री. एंड इन ए डेमोक्रेटिक कंट्री ऑल पीपल आर गिवन इक्वल राइट्स. ओके, एंड सो इन इंडिया ऑल्सो ऑल द पीपल आर गिवन इक्वल राइट टू वोट. मीन्स द सिटीजन्स और द पीपल ऑफ इंडिया दे गिव वोट एंड चूज देयर रिप्रेजेंटेटिव विदाउट एनी डिस्क्रिमिनेशन. ओके, एंड दिस रिप्रेजेंटेटिव्स मीन्स इलेक्टेड रिप्रेजेंटेटिव्स फॉर्म द गवर्नमेंट. ओके, मीन्स आफ्टर फॉर्मिंग द गवर्नमेंट द पीपल ऑफ अ डेमोक्रेटिक कंट्री देन दे एक्सपेक्ट टू द गवर्नमेंट वर्क फॉर देयर वेलफेयर. ओके, एंड थ्रू प्रोवाइडिंग द बेसिक फेसिलिटीज लाइक सच एज अफोर्डेबल हाउसेज एंड बेसिक एजुकेशन, गुड हेल्थ केयर, प्रोडक्टिविटी और प्रोडक्टिव एम्प्लॉयमेंट. Understood? So now we will have a discussion that what government do for people's welfare, particularly in providing health care services to the people. Understood? Yes. Now our next topic, health. Yes, friends, what is health? Actually, the common definition of health is the ability of a person to remain free from illness and injuries. But health is not only about this term, it is a vital aspect because healthy people can prove themselves resourceful. Yes, friends, as we know that the people of a country, or we can say that healthy, educated and skilled people of a country are known as its human resources, and these human resources are considered as an important resources for a country because they can that means they can contribute in the development of nation, and they are the only who can convert the natural resources in useful product. So means the people of a country or the human resources of a country must be healthy, skilled and educated. Okay, because only a healthy persons can work means properly. Okay, so means in simple word or in a common definition, that health is the ability to remain free of illness and injuries. Okay, but that the health is something more than that. Apart from disease, we need to think of other factors. Yes, such as safe drinking water, clean surroundings, because they affect our health in various ways. If people fail to get these basic amenities of life, so they will fall ill. Being active and in good spirits are also essential part of health. We also need to be without mental stress, because we can't be healthy for a long time if we are under mental stress strain. Understood, students? Yes, means we can think of health in many ways. Health means our ability to remain free of illness and injury, but health, it is not only about disease. Apart from disease, we need to think of other factors that affect our health. For example, like means if people get clean drinking water or a pollution free environment, so they are likely to be healthy. And on the other hand, if people do not get adequate food to eat or have to live in a polluted environment, so they will be prone to illness. So all of us would like to be active and in good spirits in whatever we may be doing. So it is not healthy to be dull, inactive, okay, or scared for long stretches of time. So we all need to be without mental strain. So all of these various aspects like safe, clean drinking water, pollution-free environment, and nutritious or adequate foods. So all these various aspects of our lives, okay, are also the part of our health. Means these things like clean drinking water, enough and nutritious food, or that pollution free surroundings. So these things, these aspects play very important role to be remain healthy. Understood? Yes. Now, health care in India. Need for health care. Yes, friends, in order to prevent the treat illness, we need appropriate healthcare centers or healthcare facilities such as healthcare centers, hospitals, laboratories for testing, ambulance services, blood banks, okay, that can provide the required care and services that patient need. So in order to run such facilities, we need health workers, nurses, qualified doctors and health professionals, like who can advise, diagnose and treat illness. So we also need some medicines and equipments also, means that are necessary for treating patients. So these facilities, all these facilities are required to take care of us. Okay, means these, all these things like hospitals, healthcare centers, laboratory, ambulance services, blood banks and the doctors, nurses. So all these aspects play an important role in our life. Okay, means they help us when we fall sick. Okay, yes. Now, healthcare centers in India. Actually, friends, here two aspects are given in two columns. Yes, first is positive aspects and second one is negative aspect. Actually, India has a large number of doctors, clinics and hospitals. Okay, and the country also has considerable experience and knowledge in running a public healthcare system. And this is a system of hospitals and health centers which are run by the government, and it has the ability to look after the health of a large section of its population which are scattered over hundreds of thousands of villages. Okay, so Miss India has the largest number of medical colleges in the world and is among the largest producers of doctors also. Approximately 15,000 new doctors qualify every year. Healthcare facilities also have grown, okay, means over the years. In 1950, if we look the data, that there were only 2,717 hospitals in India. In 1991, there were 11,174 hospitals. And in 2000, the number grew to 18,208. 18. Okay, so in this way we can say that the health facilities are also means growing with the passage of time. Okay, very quickly. And India gets a large number of medical tourists from many countries, and they come for treatment in some of the hospitals in India that compare with the best in the world. Yes, friends, medical tourist. Here one term is used, medical tourist. So who are these medical tourists? Actually, the foreigners who come to our country for medical treatment at hospitals that is charged reasonable cost and along with good facilities. So means in India that good facilities, good health facilities are available in the hospitals, and the cure of this disease are reasonable also. So these many foreigners, okay, come to our country for medical treatment, and these patients or these persons are known as medical tourists. Okay, India is the fourth largest producer of medicines in the world, and it is also a large exporter of medicines. Yes, friends, so in this way we can see that in India there is good health facilities are available. Means experienced, qualified doctors are available, a number of hospitals are there. Okay, and here all facilities are provided. And cure of some disease are reasonable also. And India is the fourth largest producer of medicine in the world. Okay, means after these facilities, now some negative aspects of also there in India about the healthcare. Like most doctors settle in urban areas. People in rural areas have to travel long distance. Okay, to reach a doctor, and the number of doctors with respect to the population is much less in rural areas. So in our positive aspect, we have studied that in India there is a large number of medical colleges and there is a large number of qualified doctor also. But all these doctors, means most of the doctors, you can say that they want to settle in the urban areas, because their facilities are available and there is the more source of income also. So in this way, people in rural area means they have to travel long distances to reach a doctor, and the number of doctor with respect to the population is also much less in the rural areas. Okay, means in this way we can say the people, those who are living in villages, means they do not get enough or good healthcare facilities. Okay, second one is there that about 5 lakh people die from tuberculosis, TB, every year. And this number is almost unchanged since independence. Okay, and it means after technological advancement, now also a number of people died every year due to of the tuberculosis in India. And almost 2 million cases of malaria are also reported every year, and this number is not decreasing. So we are not able to provide clean drinking water to all, and 21% that means 21% of all communicable disease are waterborne disease. Okay, and for example, diarrhea, worms, hepatitis, all these are the diseases which are caused due to the unsafe, unclean drinking water. Means in India, people are not getting safe, clean drinking water. Okay, and half of all children in India do not get adequate food to eat and are undernourished. Okay, so means many children are there in India, those who do not get enough amount or miss all three times of food, and many children are there those who die, okay, because due to the shortage or for not getting enough amount of food. Understood, students? So means here actually in first column or it is shown that the country also has considerable experience and knowledge in running a public healthcare system. There is a great number of doctors and hospitals, facilities are available. But our second column points out ki how poor the health situation in our India is. With all above positive developments, we are not able to provide proper healthcare facilities to people. Okay, our country has the money, knowledge and people with experience but cannot make the necessary healthcare available to all. Understood? Yes. So, what do you understand from both columns? Just I told you that first column shown that India has a dearth of qualified doctor means there is a great number of qualified, talented, skilled doctors are available and large number of clinic and hospitals too. Okay, means there is no shortage of hospital in India. There is a large number of hospitals and a large number of medical tourists come to our country for treatment at reasonable cost. This I also told you the meaning of medical tourist. Means medical tourists are the foreigners who come to our country for medical treatment at hospitals that charge reasonable cost. Yes friends, India is the fourth largest producers of medicines in the world. And it is also a large exporter of medicines. And despite all this, health situation in our country is very poor. Means all the people, especially the poor people, means they can't get the enough or means healthcare facilities. Okay, and for that many reasons are there. First one is overpopulation. Second one is corruption. Okay. Yes. Now, one story is given in your NCERT book. And that is story of Hakim Sheikh. Now, what is given in this story? Now, we will read about it. Yes. Hakim Sheikh was a member of the Pashchim Banga Khet Mazdoor Samiti. Okay. And it is an organization of agricultural laborers in West Bengal. One evening in 1992, he accidentally fell off a running train and suffered head injuries. He was in a very serious condition and needed immediate treatment. He was taken to a government hospital in Kolkata, but they refused to admit him because they did not have a spare bed. Spare bed. Understood about it, beta? Here the story of Hakim Sheikh, that he is the member of an agricultural labor organization which is in West Bengal, and in 1992 that one case happened. And what happened in this case actually, that Hakim Sheikh accidentally fell off a running train and suffered head injuries. So he was in a very serious conditions and he needed immediate treatment, but he was taken to a government hospital at Kolkata, but they refused to admit him because they did not have a spare bed. So after that, another hospital did not have the facility or the specialized doctor necessary for his treatment. So in this way, he spent 14 hours in a critical state, okay, and was taken to 8 different government hospital, but none of them admitted him, and finally he was admitted in a private hospital where he received treatment. Okay, and this organization filed, labor organization filed a case in the court. Okay, and so he spent a lot of money on his treatment. So angry and upset over in different attitude of all the hospitals that refused to admit him, Hakim Sheikh and that his organization filed a case in the court. This is there. Yes friends, means after getting or after missing reading this story, actually we can see without any doubt that adequate health care center is not available all in our country. And the reason is that private services are increasing and public services are not. So as a result, like private services are mainly available to people, but these services are concentrated in urban areas and they are very expensive also. Means all the facilities are provided in private hospitals, but poor people, okay, they could not go or reach in these hospitals for their treatment because they are very expensive. And the public hospitals are also there, means which are run by the government. But in these public hospitals, the facilities are not available. Like in the story, we have seen that Sheikh, he went in 9 public hospital. In someone, that bed facilities was not there, bed was not available. In another, doctor were not available. So, and in last, that he admitted in a private hospitals where his treatment was done. Okay, so in this situation, the Hakim Sheikh and the member of his organization file a case in the court. Actually, our constitution has given the right to life as a fundamental right. So means it is the duty of the government to provide basic health facilities to its citizens. So when they file a case in the court, okay, so the court, what decision or what order was given by the court. Now we will discuss about it. Okay. Yes. Means actually the court said that the difficulty that Hakim Sheikh had to face could have cost him his life. If a hospital cannot provide timely medical treatment to a person, so it means that this protection of life is not being given. And the court also said that it was the duty of the government to provide the necessary health services, including treatment in emergency situations, and the hospitals and medical staff must fulfill their duty of providing the necessary treatment. So Hakim Sheikh was denied treatment at various government hospitals, as we have seen in the story. So therefore, the court asked the state government to give the money that he had spent on his treatment. So students, so what conclusion or what we have understood about this story means that it is the duty of the state government to provide health care facilities to its citizens. So understood about it? Okay. Yes. Now, in this way, our today's lecture is completed. In tomorrow lecture, we will study about the types of public healthcare facilities, like public health care center and private health care centers. Okay, beta. Now I am assigning you homework. So note down this question answer, questions and the answers of this question you have to write in your fair notebook. Okay, in which the first question is, what do people in a country expect the government? In the starting of the chapter, I told you India is a democratic country and here the people expect from the government what? So this you have to write in this answer. Next one is there, where do most doctors prefer to settle? This also we have discussed. Okay. And next one is, what problems do rural people face whenever they come in a grip of an illness? And the fourth one, define health in a broader perspective. Yes, here means you will not write only the common definition, but you will describe the complete or meaning or definition of health. So understood, students? Yes. Now I want to say you that all the students are requested to send their homework in proper format. Yes, beta, I am receiving some mails in which that there was no student's name, no class and sections. Okay, so in this way, it is very difficult to find out that whose homework is this. So, miss, when you submit your homework, then please that fill this format. Write your name, your class or section, roll number and father name. Okay, so in this way, our today's lecture is completed. Tomorrow we will meet again with the next lecture of this chapter. Thank you.